Hawks and vultures are very similar looking birds, but by the end of this video you will know exactly how to tell them apart, whether they're flying or just on the ground. And get ready, because we're starting right now. So one of the best ways to tell a hawk from a vulture is to look at wing shape. Vultures usually hold their wings in a V shape, while hawks are typically more straight. Now there are of course some exceptions to this, like the zone-tailed hawk right here often holds its wings in a slight V shape, so it's not a great field mark to rely on conclusively, but it is a nice hint to get you going in the right direction. Now flight style is often different between hawks and vultures. Vultures tend to soar and glide more, while hawks tend to flap their wings, although of course this isn't always true and you shouldn't rely upon it exclusively, because red-tailed hawks like to soar and Cooper's hawks tend to flap and almost rarely ever soar. And turkey vultures do flap their wings sometimes as well. Perhaps the best way to separate a hawk from a vulture is if you look at their head. Vultures will always have a bald head, while hawks are always going to have a head with feathers. Unless something is seriously wrong with the hawk, then it would not have any feathers on its head. And so look for the bald head on vultures and then the feathered head on hawks, and that's going to be a great way to tell whether or not you're looking at a hawk or a vulture. And real quick, let's go and take a look at the wing differences. We have here on the left a turkey vulture wing, and then here on the right is, I believe, a red-tailed hawk's wing. Now, if you notice, the outer flight feathers on a turkey vulture is longer, and they're wider spaced. While here on the hawk, the outer flight feathers are closer together and are wider overall. And so when we're flying, this is kind of noticeable, actually. The turkey vulture's feathers kind of look like fingers, while the hawk's feathers are closer together, and so that can also be a good way to tell them apart. Hawks are also smaller than vultures. I have right here the wingspans of the turkey vulture, black vulture, red-tailed hawk, and I believe this is a Cooper's hawk. So the turkey vulture has the largest wingspan of 70 inches, black vulture is a little bit smaller with a wingspan of 60 inches or so. This does kind of vary between raptors. I think the females are usually larger than the males. So I believe all these measurements here are the females. And so the red-tailed hawk's wingspan is 13 inches smaller than the turkey vulture's wingspan. So 13 inches is kind of hard to notice when they're like really high up in the sky. And so this isn't a great way to separate them, but it can kind of give you a clue as to if you're looking at a hawk or a vulture. And black vultures are native to the southern United States, and I believe their range goes all the way down into South America. And a good way to separate them from hawks is, again, these outer flight feathers look kind of like fingers and are skinnier and farther apart from each other, but they're also a silver color. And let's see, right here is a picture of one flying. And if we zoom in, you can kind of see there's a silver color. And if the sun hits it just right, this is actually very obvious. And so that is not only a good way to separate the black vulture from the turkey vulture, but no hawks have silvery wingtips like the black vulture does. And now there's actually one species of hawk that is very similar to a vulture and looks a lot like a vulture, and that is the zone-tailed hawk. And here's how you separate it. So a zone-tailed hawk has a feathered head and a yellow beak. Like we said earlier, vultures all have bald heads, and so look for the feathers on the head, and vultures also don't have yellow beaks. So we got the white stripe on the tail with the yellow feet, and then we also have a barred underwing right here. Vultures, like I said earlier, are all black, so they're not going to have that barred underwing. And so when you put all these field marks together, it's quite easy to notice a zone-tailed hawk once you get within range of being able to see these features. Now, I talked a little bit about this earlier, but vultures do not have any color. So if you see a hawk like this broad-winged hawk here that has some color like white or red in it, then it is not going to be a vulture, because the two vultures that live in the United States do not have any color aside from the little bit of silver in the black vulture's wingtips and the red on the turkey vulture's head. Size would also be a pretty big difference. If the broad-winged hawk were to be compared right next to a turkey vulture, the wing size would be pretty noticeable as well. And I used the red-tailed hawk in some examples earlier, and if you want to learn more about this large raptor, go ahead and click on the video right here.